Marvel's next films will bring diversity, on screen and off. Los Angeles Marvel's push for more women and people of color in its immensely popular film franchise is extending to behind the camera as it launches its next round of films after the massive success of Avengers: Endgame. Of the five films the superhero studio announced at Comic-Con on Saturday, only one is set to be directed by a white man. It's about fresh voices and new voices and great filmmakers who can continue to clear the Marvel Cinematic Universe into new places, Marvel Studios President Kevin Feige said in an interview after the studio's explosive Hall H panel. And I am as proud of that lineup of directors as you saw today as any. In addition to a crew of women and people of color at the helm of the upcoming Marvel film, the weekend's announcements promised more diversity on screen. First up for release is the long-awaited solo film starring Scarlett Johansson as the Black Widow, the lethal assassin she has played for nearly a decade. The film is set for release in May 2020. Johansson said the search for Black Widow director Kate Shortland wasn't easy. It's really interesting because when we were looking for a director, you start to see some of the systemic problems, Johansson said. Even looking for a female director who has had enough experience, who has had the opportunity to have the experience to sit at the helm of something huge like this, you know, choices are limited because of that. And it sucks. The actress added that she was proud to see the diversity on stage during Marvel's Hall H panel. Looking out on that stage tonight, it was incredible. It was really moving, also just to see how incredibly diverse the universe is and reflects what we see all around us. It's incredible, she said. In terms of more diversity, Black Widow is just the beginning. The Eternals will feature a cast full of actors of color, including Kumail Nanjiani, Brian Tyree Henry, and Salma Hayek. Simu Liu will become Marvel's first big-screen Asian-American superhero when Shang-Chi and The Legend of the Ten Rings is released in February 2021. Natalie Portman will play a female Thor in the new Thor, Love and Thunder, which will also feature Tessa Thompson's character, Valkyrie, as the MCU's first superhero. First of all, as new thing, of Asgard, she needs to find her queen. So that will be her first order of business. She has some ideas. Keep you posted, Thompson said during the panel. Faith later confirmed the news in an interview with the Exidio 9. The studio is also reviving one of Marvel's most iconic black characters, Blade, previously played by Wesley Snipes, with the help of Academy Award winner Mahershala Ali. Page told the Associated Press that right after winning his second Academy Award for Green Book earlier this year, Ali set up a meeting. Within 10 minutes, he basically was like, "What's happening with Blade? I want to do it." And we went, "That's what's happening with Blade. Let's do it," Page said. Captain Marvel, released in March, was the first of Marvel Studios' film to be centered entirely on a female character. It earned millions domestically, and along with the DC Comics film Wonder Woman has created momentum for more films with female heroes leading the way. Marvel is really focused on having very strong female characters at the forefront of their stories, said actress Rachel Weisz, who also stars in Black Widow. And I think that's great. This film has got three. It's Scarlett, Florence Pugh, myself. So I think yes, they are doing wonderful work to represent women, people of color, and tell different kinds of stories. The sliver of Hollywood still on the outside of the Marvel Cinematic Empire was paying close attention to the move. Actress, writer and director Lena Waithe tweeted Sunday, "Captain America is black. Thor is a woman. The news laid off two Oscars. 007 is a black woman. And the Little Mermaid bound to have lost. Expletive. Just. Got. Real. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.